Welcome back to the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. If you are having problems or difficulty at times finding the moon with your C star, whether that be your S50 or your S30 or any C star, this video will give you a quick solution to that. It'll be very simple. Whether you're using also equatorial mode setup or your alt azimuth setup. So let's get to it. So as you see here in equatorial mode first, what I'm going to show you is that I actually did not do any leveling of the C star whatsoever. There is also no compass calibration being done. I am not also doing any horizontal calibration. As you can see, I have that under skip horizontal calibration. And no adjusting leveling is needed because in equatorial mode, it's not really necessary. You can do more fine-tune adjustments once you're actually going to do your polar aligned deviation, but no need to level your C-star when you first start. In equatorial mode, not absolutely necessary. So in the event that you cannot locate or find the moon with your C-star, take note of this because it's only three very simple steps. But before I start that, what I want you to know is that I noticed that in equatorial mode, it was very, very simple to find the moon with just one go. Okay, so what I'm going to show you is what happens if you cannot find the moon with just one step, with just your click go to moon. Let's start. All you have to do is find two of the brightest stars in your night sky that are naked eye visible, one to the east and one to the west, or let's say one to the north and one to the south. Now, they don't have to be exactly that far apart away from each other, but just make sure they are relatively far apart. So step one, what I'm going to show you is we're going to, for instance, find the star Arcturus, naked eye visible. It is on the east from where I am at this moment. On the homepage, I went into my stargazing, search object, and type in the name of the star. So you're gonna click on go to, and once your C star blue frame outline gets to your star, it will automatically get out of this window and pop into your stargazing. So once you see that your star is in the center of the stargazing page, you can go ahead and minimize, go back to your sky atlas and press on the word sync. All right, so before we move on to the next step, go ahead and hit that like button. If you're finding this content valuable, make sure you subscribe so that way you won't miss out on any videos from the Astro Room, and show your support by seeing the link in the description to donate any amount and buy me a coffee. All right, so for the next step, we're almost done here. I'm basically now going to just do the exact same thing we just did. I'm going to instead though choose a different star and going to sync that one as well. So basically a star on the other side, which what I'm using is Pollux. Once you get the star in the stargazing, you minimize once again, click on sync. Once that succeeds, you are good to go. Now your C star, you can go directly to find the moon. Make sure that you are not gonna be in the stargazing mode to find the moon, but instead solar system mode, okay? So go to the solar system mode, find the moon, and this works every single time. Once you've already synced two stars, you should have absolutely no problem finding the moon.